Hello and welcome to the video tutorial of an introduction to microcontroller programming. This video tutorial is designed to those who are willing to learn from the very basic concepts of microcontroller programming, and by following this video tutorial you can learn from the very basic concepts and then step by step you can improve your knowledge and move to advanced concepts. Okay, now let's move to our table of content. First part of this tutorial I'm going to introduce you the microcontroller device. In this part you will learn what is a microcontroller, and next we are move to introduction to PIC16F84A microcontroller. This microcontroller is very good for the beginners to learn the basic concepts of microcontroller programming, and the next part is dedicated to introduce you the hardware. In this part I'm going to teach you how to create your own programmer. This is a very basic programmer, and you can create this by your own. If you have a basic knowledge of electronic, you can connect your microcontroller to your PC or your laptop computer using this programmer. Next part of this video is to introduce you the software. In this part I will introduce you some cool software that you can enjoy, and you can write programs, simulate them and discover how your program is working. Okay, now the next part is your first project. This is the very important part. You can learn to create a basic project. In this part, apply practically the concepts you learn in this tutorial. In the first project, I'm going to teach you how to write the assembly instructions for the PIC16F84A microcontroller, and not only assembly, using high level instructions and using Micro C programming language. And also I'm going to show you how to simulate your program using the powerful simulators. The simulators are some of the software that you can discover how your program is working, and also how to connect your microcontroller to the computer and program it, and several things I will show you. What is a microcontroller? A microcontroller is a small computer on a single integrated circuit containing a processor core, memory and programmable input-output peripherals. A microcontroller is a small computer, not just like a digital IC. Microcontroller is a complicated device. It has a processor core, memory and programmable input-output ports and several things inside the microcontroller. But the appearance is just like a digital IC. You can buy different kind of microcontrollers from the market that are designed for different purposes. You can program the microcontroller as your own, and after you program, the microcontroller is ready to work for you. Where you can find microcontrollers? In latest electronic devices, digital complicated electronic devices, you can find microcontrollers, just like digital cameras, DVD players, washing machines. In this kind of electronically controlled devices you can find microcontrollers. And not only in digital electronic devices, motor cars and the latest vehicles has electronically controlled systems like automated brake systems, you can find microcontrollers. In the industries, there are a lot of automated controlling systems, just like robotics. Those devices are controlling using microcontrollers. And what PIC? The PIC is stand for peripheral interface controllers. PIC microcontrollers are we are using today. And here you can see some of the pictures of microcontrollers, and you can compare the size. The appearance is just like digital ICs, but the microcontroller is a single chip computer. And another important thing I want to tell you is microcontroller is not an intelligent device. It is made of using flip-flops, counters and arithmetical and logical units. Just like a microprocessor, it cannot make decisions without your help. That means you are the person who programmed the microcontroller. If you program a microcontroller using a very accurate and very efficient program, the microcontroller is also working efficiently and accurately. The function of the microcontroller is totally dependent on the programmer. What is the difference between a CPU or microprocessor and the microcontroller? Microprocessor is inside our computers. It cannot work individually. It needs the help of another devices, just like memory and motherboard and hard disk. Lot of devices are required to the function of the microprocessor. But in the microcontroller or microchip, everything is integrated in the single microchip. It doesn't need another devices. What you have to do is supply the correct voltage and program it using a correct program. Then it is ready to work for you. Okay, Now we are moving to the PIC16F84A microcontroller. This is the microcontroller that we are using in this video tutorial, and this is a very good microcontroller for the beginners to understand the function of the microcontroller. Okay, let's see some of the features of this microcontroller. It has 35 instruction set. It is not very complicated, only 35 instruction sets. You can learn fast and you can work with these instructions easily. It has 20 MHz clock and 1 kilobyte of program memory and 68 bytes RAM, and you can 10,000 times reprogram this microchip. You can program, erase, and again you can program this microcontroller. Okay, now let's see the data sheet of the PIC16F84A microcontroller. This is the data sheet of PIC16F84A microcontroller. You can download this data sheet from the Microchip website. It is free. Okay, let's see some of the things inside this data sheet. And here you can see the pins and the structure of this microcontroller. It has 18 pins. Some of the pins are you can use to program the microcontroller and to supply the voltage. And some of the pins are dedicated to as ports. We can use these ports to get outputs from the microcontroller and supply inputs to the microcontroller. And here you can see the inside structure of this microcontroller. This is the block diagram. You can see how the important components are integrated, and you don't want to worry about these things now. You will learn these things later. And another important things I want to show you is the register structure of this microcontroller. It is here. This is the registers structure diagram, and you must have basic understanding of these registers because we are always writing programs to these registers. And there are two sections of these registers, and they are named bank 0 and bank 1. And another important thing I want to show is the instruction descriptions. These are the instruction sets of the PIC16F84A microcontroller. Earlier I mentioned that there are 34 instructions, and we can use these instructions to write programs. Here the descriptions, every instruction has its description. You can read this instruction and understand what are the tasks, what are the functions of these instructions, and we can use these instructions when we are writing assembly codes with MPLAB. Now we are moving to the hardware part. What are the hardware that required to microcontroller programming? And before I introduce you the hardware or the programmer, I want to show you some of the steps that we are following when we are programming microcontrollers. And here you can see basically three steps. And first we are writing our code, writing our instruction sets using assembly or C, just like high level language C or assembly, and we write the code, and after write the code we compile, and then we get machine level instructions can be understood by the microcontroller. After we create the machine level instructions, then we can program or insert these machine level instructions to the microcontroller. We need hardware to this task. Okay, you can see here a picture of a programmer. What is a programmer? Programmer is a device that we can use to connect microcontroller to the computer. We are using computers to write programs, compile them, and program our microcontroller. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create your own programmer. It is a very simple device. You can build it by your own if you have a very basic knowledge of electronics. This is the schematic of the JDM programmer, and this is the microcontroller. You can see what are the ports and what are the pins that we are using to connect this microcontroller to the programmer. We connect this programmer through the serial port to the computer. Okay, this is the build version of JDM programmer, and this is a very small circuit you can create on a it is on a Vero board, and you can use a project board or even a PCB. And here a serial port is connected, and okay.